Today we will learn about the Reserve Bank of India. Reserve Bank of India is India's central bank. It is the apex monetary institution which supervises, regulates, controls and develops the monetary and financial system in the country. The Reserve Bank of India was established on April 10, 1935 under the RBI Act of 1934. Initially, it was contributed as a private shareholders bank. With the fully paid up capital of 5 crores, it was nationalized on January 1, 1949. RBI performs various traditional central banking functioning as well as undertaking different promotional and development measures for the dynamic requirement of the country. The main objectives of Reserve Bank of India are: number one, it regulates the issue of currency of India, currency notes. It keeps the foreign exchange reserves of the country. It establishes the monetary stability in the country. It develops the financial structure of the country on sound lines of the national socio-economic objectives and policies. Main functions of RBI are note issue, currency notes. The RBI has the monopoly of note issue in the country. It has the sole right to issue currency notes of all denominations except 1 rupee notes, which are issued by the Ministry of Finance, Government of India. The RBI Act acts as the only source of legal tender money because even the 1 rupee notes are circulated through it. The RBI has a separate department which is entrusted with the job of issuing currency notes. The RBI has adopted minimum reserve system of note issue. Since 1957, it maintains a gold and foreign exchange reserves of rupees 200 crores, out of which at least 115 crores should be in the form of gold. Second function is bankers to gold. The RBI acts as the banker agent and the advisor to the Government of India. It maintains and operates government deposits. It collects and makes payments on behalf of the government. It helps the government to float new loans and manages the public debts. It sells for the central government treasury bills of 91 days duration. It makes ways and developing finance to the government for carrying out 5-year plans. It undertakes foreign exchange transactions on behalf of central government. It acts as the agent of Government of India in later dealing with the international financial institutions. It advises the government on all financial matters such as loans, operations, investments, agriculture and industrial finance, banking, planning, economic development, etc. Next function is Bankers Bank. The Reserve Bank of India acts as Bankers Bank in the following aspects. One is, every bank is under the statutory obligation to keep certain minimum of cash reserves with RBI. The purpose of these reserves are to enable the Reserve Bank to extend financial assistance to the scheduled banks in terms of emergency and acts as lender of the last resort. According to Banking Regulation Act 1949, all the scheduled banks are required to maintain with RBI minimum cash reserves of 4% of their demand liabilities. That is called cash reserve ratio. Custodian, next function is custodian of exchange reserves. The RBI of the Reserve Bank of India is the custodian of Indian foreign exchange reserves. It maintains and stabilizes the external value of rupee, administration of exchange control and other restrictions imposed by the government, and manages the foreign exchange reserves. Initially, the stability of exchange reserve was maintained through selling and purchasing sterling at fixed rate But after India became member of IMF in 1947, the rupee was de-linked with the sterling and became a multilateral convertible currency. Therefore, the RBI now sells and purchases foreign currency and also fixes the rate of selling and buying to foreign currencies. All Indian remittances to foreign currencies and foreign remittances to India are made through RBI. Next function is controller of credit. As the central bank of the country, the RBI undertakes the responsibilities of controlling credit in order to ensure the internal price stability and promote economic growth. Through this function, RBI attempts to achieve price stability in the country and avoids inflation and deflation tendencies in the country. Next function is ordinary banking function. RBI also performs various banking functions. Number one, it accepts the deposits from the central government, state government, and even private individuals without interest. It buys, sells, and discounts the bills of exchange and promissory notes of the scheduled banks without restrictions. It grants loans and advances to the central and state governments, local authorities, scheduled banks, cooperative banks, repayable within the 90 days. Next business is forbidden, that is forbidden business. Reserve Bank of India is forbidden to do the following businesses. Number one, it can neither participate nor directly provide financial assistance to business, trade or industry. It cannot give loans against mortgage of security. It cannot purchase immovable property except for its own offices and officers. Next one is promotional and development functions. The central bank of a country is not involved in development and promotional functions in any country. However, the RBI was at the beginning of the planning era in the country since 1951. And with the introduction of various welfare schemes and activities by the central government, had felt the need to participate in the economic growth of the country. RBI has set up NABARD, National Bank for Agriculture and NABARD, National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. RBI has realized that the deposit mobilization could be possible only across the country in order to rule out the inefficient and unresourceful banks. RBI conducts periodically checking in the banking sector. Last one is miscellaneous functions. Bankers Training College has been set up to extend the training facilities to supervision staff and the offices of commercial banks. Agreement have been made to impart training to cooperative personnel also. RBI collects and publishes statistical information relating to banking, finance, credit, currency, agricultural and industrial production, etc. It also publishes the various results of various studies and reviews economic situation of country in the monthly bulletins and periodicals. Thank you.